Hey, you guys. It has been a long, long time since I did a cool story club. But I really just felt like I really needed to talk to you guys about something. As you can tell, I'm in New York City right now, and I just flew in from London yesterday. And in London, I watched a little thing called the Xbox reveal. Obviously, you can tell from my face that I didn't really like it that much. I wasn't really that impressed. And I think that that's not just me. I think that that's most of the internet. And the internet's always right. So what didn't I like about the Xbox One? Well, for starters, all right, so number one, backwards compatibility. Look, I get it. You know, we need to progress, and when you use certain chips into certain technologies, you're unable to have backwards compatibility. But figure your shit out. Just figure it out. Because now I can't use any of my games on my new Xbox, so in order to play my old games, I have to keep my big old clunky Xbox around. And that's kind of crappy, isn't it? I don't want two Xboxes. Which brings me to my second point. I won't be having two Xboxes. I'm going to be having one Xbox and one some sort of like media center, which will allow me to watch television, go on my Facebook, watch Netflix, go shopping, Skype with my parents, bake fucking soft serve ice cream. I don't want my vibrator to make me a cup of tea. I want my vibrator to vibrate. Because what's the point of having a fucking vibrator if it doesn't vibrate? But look, if my vibrator vibrated really well and made a really decent cup of tea, that would be one thing. But that never, never happens. And this is proven by the Xbox reveal. I saw no gameplay. I saw Forza 5, all right? Fine for people who like racing games, but did everybody know that that's also going to be on the PlayStation? Same with FIFA, which I don't really give that much of a crap about, but that's also gonna be on the PlayStation. So we're left with what? Call of Duty. Awesome. Great, we have Call of Duty. Literally the only thing I was excited about in the reveal was the dogs. What I'm sort of starting to notice about the game industry is that it's really like sort of splitting off into two industries. There's the big blockbuster game industry, and then there's the indie game industry. Like the actual, where the heart of the game industry is going is into this sort of indie game industry. It's just like blockbuster movies and independent movies. All of the indie game companies have the technology to make blockbuster games. But because they're not attached to huge studios, shut up! Because they're not attached to huge studios, they're able to go under the radar and make all these amazing games with all these technologies, not spend a whole shit ton of money, but make a decent amount of money back. Because of the existence of blockbuster games, that doesn't mean that we aren't going to have good independent games. So it's not like I'm devastated. I know that there's still hope, but it's just really interesting to see how the evolution of technology and gameplay is. It's really interesting to see. So Xbox, stop giving my fucking vibrator extra functions. Just make it vibrate really well and you'll make lots of people happy. All right, good. I'm glad that we sorted that out. Thanks for watching. Cool story, Chloe. New York walk edition. Obviously, I'm out of shape. I think I've exerted enough energy for today. Thank you. So I'm just going to go take a nap.
You're tiny. You also dropped something.